Here I come.
Sin is a cry guilty at the Most High Lord. So some people might say, who are we? Why are we wearing all white before you? Let's go to the scriptures and see. Who are we? According to the Bible, we are not Bahamas. We are not Haitians. We are not Americans. We are not Negroes. According to the Bible, we are the children of Israel.
God.
Let's get the scripture. Let's go. Romans chapter 9, verse 4. Who are Israelites? To whom pertaineth the adoption and the glory and the covenants and the giving of the law and the service of God and the promises. You see that, brothers and sisters? So according to the scriptures, our Israelite is someone who was given the law according to the bloodline of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. We are before you today. So we are doing the service of God. If someone want to know why are we are here to do the service of God. Let us awake out of sleep. Let's read it.
Romans chapter 13, verse 11. And God, knowing the time, that now it is high time to awake out of sleep. For now is our salvation, now that when we believe.
See, this ain't nothing with the Christian church. Brothers and sisters, we are here in the last days to awaken our people. This is now high time that we wake out of sleep. We need to come back to the true identity. This is now high time, read it. This is now high time to wake out of sleep. For now is our salvation, now that when we believe. You see that, brothers and sisters? Who gave us salvation? We thought salvation came from Christianity today, pagan Christianity. We thought 7 days of Venus. We thought Jehovah's Witness. We thought the Pentecostal church gave us salvation. According to the scriptures, brothers and sisters, our Israelite, what we pertaining to the laws, what we do the service of God.
So what you see in here,
brothers and sisters, is the service of the Most High.
There is no truth, nor mercy, nor knowledge of God in the land.
You know why, brothers and sisters? Because we broke the laws. According to the Bible, we broke the God, from the God of Israel, the Creator. He didn't give us religion to separate us.
God.
He didn't give us religion to separate us. But he gave us a law that we can have a moral law, a ceremonial law. You understand? So why, brothers and sisters, why keep going to these Christian churches? Why keep going to these Christian churches and they ain't giving us nothing? Because the Most High have a controversy with Nassau. Because there's no truth in the land. Read it again. It's not my words. It is from the scriptures. Read. Hear the word of the Lord, you children of Israel. For the Lord have a controversy with the inhabitants of the land. Because there's no truth, nor mercy, nor knowledge of God in the land. Continue. By swearing and lying and killing and stealing and committing adultery, they break out and blood touches blood. So you see that, brothers and sisters, it is evident that killing, lying,
it just did.
Stealing,
I'm here with God.
You see that, brothers and sisters? The reason for the fuck now so being this way, the reason why the crime rate is so high is, guess what? We broke the laws of the Most High. According to the scripture, therefore shall thou fall in the day, and the prophet also shall fall with thee in the night. Continue, and I will destroy thy mother. They said, my people are destroyed for lack of knowledge. People are destroyed for lack of knowledge, brothers and sisters. Because God has rejected knowledge, I will also reject thee. So that's why, brothers and sisters, the Most High is rejecting our kids. Our offspring, that's why we have generation curses. Because we forsook the laws of the Most High. We're living in the last days. Now everybody is transgressing. We're seeing curses. We're seeing the curses again continually. Brothers and sisters, take the chance by keeping the laws of the Most High.
Jeremiah chapter 23, verses 1 to 4.
Woe be unto the pastors that destroy and scatter the sheep of my pasture. Woe be unto the pastors who scatter the Most High people. What y'all seeing now, brothers and sisters, is evident. It's a prophecy. When you see us all in white, we wear the fringes. We're coming back to our laws. You see young men who start families, who keeping the laws, who
living an honest life. That's what you see in brothers and sisters. But the pastors are destroying and scattering the Most High people. We won't be unto the pastors that destroy and scatter the sheep of my pasture, saith the Lord.
Continue.
Therefore, thus saith the Lord God of Israel, against the pastors that feed my people. You have scattered my flock and driven them away and have not visited them. So you see that, brothers and sisters, pastors lying. So the Most High said, woe and be to the pastors. Read that again. Woe be unto the pastors that destroy and scatter the sheep of my pasture, saith the Lord. Therefore, thus saith the Lord God of Israel, against the pastors that feed my people. You have scattered my flock and driven them away and have not visited them. Behold, I will visit upon you the evil of your doings, saith the Lord. So you see that people? The Most High say he will visit the pastors who lie and tell you the laws of God is done away with. The same pastors who tell you this, they're taking your money. According to the Bible, the Most High will visit those pastors. Romans chapter 11, verse 1. I say then, have God cast away his people? God forbid. I also am an Israelite of the seed of Abraham. So, brothers and sisters, he's reading from the book of Romans 11, the New Testament. Paul says he's an Israelite according to his bloodline. According to the scriptures, the Most High is calling back his people. I have reserved to myself 7,000 men who have not bowed down the knee to the image of Baal. You see that, brothers and sisters? So according to the scriptures, it's a remnant. You ask yourself, why am I still in these Christian church? Why am I still doing the same thing and getting sick?
Look at me.
Why am I having cancer? Why am I going through all of this? Romans chapter 1, verse 20. For the invisible things of him from creation of the world are clearly seen, being understood by the things that are made, even his eternal power and Godhead. So brothers and sisters, so Paul is saying that now, the reason why we see homosexuals, we see them killing, because they change the natural use of God. And then guess what? They change everything with the Most High put in the beginning. God established in the books of the prophets. They changed everything because that when they knew God, they glorified him not as God. Neither were thankful, but became vain in their imaginations. And their foolish heart was darkened. Prophesying themselves to be wise, they became fools. Prophesying themselves to be wise, they became fools, brothers and sisters.
Statues have fallen. We have starved them of our prayers.
Because the Most High into a lie. So now what we see now, brothers and sisters, is people going to these churches and they're coming back with nothing, no substance, nothing, no knowledge, no understanding. So our people is going to the hospitals and guess what? The pharmaceuticals is making money off of us.
This is how we as fishers live.
We are like merchandise. So, according to the scriptures, it's only one God, one faith, one understanding. But the Bahamas people has accepted Muslims. That being from East, from the East. That's a religion that was made. We got Jehovah's Witness. We got seven men that did it. Those religions were man-made, brothers and sisters. According to the Bible,
John chapter 2, verse 4. That said, I know him and keep him not his commandments, is a liar.
So you see that, brothers and sisters? So some of you might say, I go to church on Sunday. The Bible said, do not say I know him and keep him not his commandments, is a liar. And the truth is not in him. The truth is not in you. According to the scriptures, if you go to church on Sunday.
Bless me, Father, for I've sinned. It's been 3 hours since my last confession.
3 hours? Speedy sinner, I like it.
If you keep Christmas, it's pagan. If you keep Thanksgiving, it's pagan.
Ooh, you looking for this?
If you follow out the Easter, it's pagan.
What is it?
According to the scriptures, keep his commandments. The Sabbath, according to the scriptures, 6 days. We're coming into the Sabbath right now. A lot of people are breaking the Sabbath. And they go to church on Sunday and say, God bless me. According to the scriptures, you are a liar. Read the last part. But whoso keepeth his word, in him verily is the love of God perfected. Thereby, we know that we are in him. that said, he abided in him, or himself, on sanctified to all. You see that, brothers and sisters? So, if you go into church on Sunday, it's pagan. Come back to the Sabbath, according to the Bible. Let's get it. Exodus chapter 20 and verse 8. Let's get Exodus chapter 20 and verse 8. And let's see the scriptures on the Sabbath. The pastors be lying to you. And they change Sabbath, Friday, Sunday, into Sunday, and they call it their Sabbath. Let's go. If you say you as a Bible believer, you should believe all things that's written in the Bible. Let's read it. Exodus chapter 20, verse 8. Remember the Sabbath to keep it holy. 6 days shall thou labor and do all thy work. But the seventh day is the Sabbath of the Lord thy God. Brothers and sisters, so according to the Bible, 6 days we should labor, and the seventh day of the Sabbath, we should be resting, we should be having a holy convocation according to the Bible. We shouldn't be partying. We shouldn't be drinking.
Starting bid, 1 million. 1 million. Can I get 1 5?
So, if you say you're a Bible believer, brothers and sisters, and you're breaking the Sabbath, according to the Most High, you are transgressing His laws. Let's see the hard booty of a man. Let's get it. Ecclesiastes chapter 12, verse 13. What is that, the conclusion of the whole matter? Fear God and keep His commandments. So the whole conclusion of the whole matter, brothers and sisters, is to fear the Most High and keep His commandments. That's the whole duty of a man. Read that again. Let us hear the conclusion of the whole matter. Fear God and keep His commandments. For this is the whole duty of man. So if you want to know what your duty, if you want to know what to do, the whole duty of a man, brothers and sisters, is to come back to His God.